Ladies and gentlemen, now taking the field are soldiers of your United States Army. Please stand and join in singing the Army song.
March along, sing a song with the Army of the Free. Come the brave, come the true, who have fought to victory. We're the Army and proud of our name. We're the Army and proudly proclaim. First you fight for the right and you build nations might. The Army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fighting till the battle's won. And the Army goes rolling along. Then it's high, high, hey, the Army's on its way. Count off the gain and found its throne. So wherever we go, you will always know that the Army goes rolling along.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the soldiers in front of you are from the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, which traces its lineage back to the 1st American Regiment of 1784. Facing the audience are two platoons from the Commander-in-Chief's Guard, patterned after George Washington's personal guard. In the ceremonial blues uniform, the United States Army drill team is on my left, and Honor Guard Company's 2nd platoon is on my right. At the center of today's formation is the Continental Color Guard, and located behind the national colors is the United States Army Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps. To the rear of the formation are the soldiers of the United States Army Band Pershing Zone. The Presidential Salute Battery will be firing tonight, and the horses in tonight's ceremony are Peter, Tony, Shorefire, and Randy. The commander of troops is Command Sergeant Major James I. Hill, Jr., Command Sergeant Major, 4th Battalion, 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard. In 1922, the War Department granted permission for the Old Guard to pass in review with bayonets fixed in recognition of their heroic bayonet charge at the Battle of Cerro Gordo in the Mexican War. The Old Guard will now fix bayonets to the traditional beat of the drum. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening's Twilight Tattoo is in honor of Vietnam veterans and their families. Today's guests include members of the United States of America Vietnam War Commemoration, the congressionally authorized program to thank and honor Vietnam veterans and their families. the National League of POW-MIA Families, the Defense POW-MIA Accounting Agency, the Paralyzed Veterans of America, the Veterans of Foreign Wars, and the American Legion. Tonight we pay tribute to our Vietnam veterans, the majority of whom were drafted and thrust into a very controversial war during one of the most tumultuous points in our nation's history. Today's members of the All-Volunteer Army recognize that they stand on your shoulders, for your sacrifice during and after the war have made us a better army and a better nation. For many veterans, the fight did not end once they left the jungles of Vietnam. They courageously faced many struggles and selflessly fought for the next generation of warriors. However, their efforts were not in vain. Though many would never experience the benefits of their hard work and dedication, they improved the lives of future veterans. Thanks to you, America treasures and cares for its veterans. As the Sergeant Major of the Army, I am dedicated to the health, welfare, and viability of the force. America's safety rests on those who have given so much, yet asked for so little in return. I am eternally grateful to you and your families. At this time, tonight's host, Sergeant Major of the Army, Daniel A. Daly, asks that every veteran please stand and be recognized. Sergeant Major of the Army Daly also asks that each person rise for a moment of silence in honor of those who made the ultimate sacrifice on behalf of a grateful nation. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the presentation of the command. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored to have special guests for tonight's ceremony. The Honorable Dr. Fran Harvey, the 19th Secretary of the Army. The Honorable Woody Goldberg, civilian aide to the Secretary of the Army. Lieutenant General Gary H. Cheek, the Director of the Army Staff. And Ms. Ann Mills Griffiths, Chairman of the Board and Chief Executive Officer for the National League of POW and MIA Families. Twilight Tattoo celebrates America's Army, the strength of the nation. Your Army remains the nation's force of decisive action, globally responsive, and regionally engaged. The soldiers of our Army are our nation's most trusted professionals. For over 241 years, their selfless service has protected our hard-earned rights and liberties. They are the steadfast defenders of not only our Army's proud history and rich traditions, but also of our country's way of life. No matter the task, the environment, or the difficulty, America's Army will always be ready to accomplish the mission. Our nation's greatest generations are built on the strength of America's strongest citizens, our servicemen and women in uniform. Once again, welcome to Fort Myer and this evening's special performance of Twilight Tattoo, Army Strong. Ready? The origin of American military music can be traced to the fifers and drummers of the Revolutionary War. This musical heritage is represented today by the soldiers of the United States Army Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps. These active duty musicians honor the soldiers of the past while displaying the discipline, professionalism, and precision of today's Army to audiences around the globe. Thank you. As the Corps concludes their performance with their stately and traditional troop step, we ask that you keep in mind the men and women of all the United States Armed Forces that currently serve in harm's way. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the United States Army Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps.
Listen, my children, and you shall hear of the midnight ride of Paul Revere.
To arms! The regulars are out! To arms! The regulars are out!
The American Revolution was our 8-year-long struggle for independence. The conflict witnessed the birth of our nation's army on 14 June 1775. Though the raw militia units that comprised that force were severely tested in the early years of the Revolution, under the leadership of General George Washington, a professional American army emerged from the trials and tribulations of Valley Forge as a trained, battle-tested, and highly organized fighting force. Less than a generation after the American Revolution, the Army was again called upon to defend our hard-won liberties and national sovereignty in the War of 1812. In battles that raged from Canada to the Gulf of Mexico, American soldiers endured and persevered, as our nation's capital and the entire Chesapeake region was threatened in the summer of 1814. A small force of soldiers and militia held out against an invading British army and fleet at a small post near Baltimore, Maryland.
Make ready, take aim, fire! Advance, firelocks. We've been under constant attack the last few days. The enemy has pressed us hard, and they've been shelling Fort McHenry almost nonstop. But the men endure the horrors of battle and bombardment like veterans. The strength and courage of the regular soldiers and militia remain unbroken, despite the hardships. We have a bond. We trust in each other and our officers, and we know we will prevail. This morning at dawn, the fort's commander ordered an enormous flag to be raised to show the enemy that we will not be defeated. They say it can be seen for miles. This flag is our nation's symbol, our badge of honor, and it will not be lowered for this or for any foe.
Ladies and gentlemen, over 200 years ago, our national anthem was born as Francis Scott Key observed our glorious flag continuing to fly over the ramparts at Fort McHenry. Please rise and join in singing the Star-Spangled Banner.
Can you see by the dawn's what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket red bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the
seated. America's army played a pivotal role in shaping the early republic, helping to open the West and secure new territory. But in 1860, clouds of war gathered once again on the horizon. During the four bloody years of the Civil War, brave soldiers from both sides of a divided nation fought and suffered in battles that raged in places called Shiloh, Antietam, Gettysburg, and the Wilderness. Over 600,000 Americans died in the war between the states, as brother fought brother to determine the fate of the country. Peace eventually came on a spring day in April 1865 at Appomattox, Virginia, when the two armies met to end the conflict and began binding up the nation's wounds. The Union was preserved. Less than a century ago, World War I erupted on the European continent. The United States Army, which had first appeared on the world stage during the Spanish-American War, was now called upon to deploy overseas and defeat the armies of the German Kaiser. In vicious trench warfare that raged across the battlefields of Western Europe, soldiers of the American Expeditionary Force, to include members of the famous 369th Infantry Regiment, a unit comprised of African-American soldiers known as the Harlem Hellfighters, stood side by side with America's allies, bringing about a victory in what was to become known as the Great War.
Over there, send the word over there, that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drums are rum-tumming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer, send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't come back till it's over over there. Johnny, get your gun, get your gun, get your gun, grab it on the run, on the run, on the run. Hear them calling you
and me, every son of liberty. Hurry, don't delay, go today right away. Your daddy will be glad to have had such a lad. Tell your sweetheart not to pine, to be glad her boy's in line. Over there, over there, send the word over there, that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drums are rum-tumming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer, send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't come back till it's over, over there.
Though World War I has also been called the war to end all wars, less than a generation after that conflict, the forces of tyranny and oppression again threatened our country and her allies in the Second World War. The Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor 75 years ago signaled America's entry into World War II. For 4 years, American soldiers and millions of men and women on the home front fought and worked together to decisively defeat the Axis powers around the globe. American forces stormed across the plains of Europe as they made the final push to defeat our Nazi foes. At the same time, half a world away, tens of thousands of soldiers assaulted island fortresses throughout the Pacific to stop the Japanese advance. Despite fanatic resistance by the enemy, American soldiers would emerge victorious in both the European and Pacific theaters in 1945. The peace that so many had fought and died for in World War II lasted just a few short years. In June 1950, the Cold War turned hot as American forces joined with the United Nations to resist communist aggression in Korea. Over 1.8 million American service members, many of them veterans of World War II, fought desperate battles at places like Heartbreak Ridge, Porkchop Hill, and Sandbag Castle, before an armistice, which continues to this day, was signed, and the fighting came to an end. Less than a decade after the end of hostilities in Korea, the Army was again called upon to confront our nation's enemies in Southeast Asia. The Vietnam War was our nation's longest conflict before the campaign in Afghanistan. As we commemorate the 50th anniversary of the war in Vietnam, we honor the more than 58,000 Americans who lost their lives. 1,619 Americans remain unaccounted for and are never forgotten. The men and women of our Army fought in incredibly challenging conditions, but never wavered in their courage and commitment to the nation and each other.
I'm on my second tour in Vietnam. Back when I got draft notice, I wasn't really sure what to expect. My father was a soldier in World War II, and now I guess it's my time to serve. I made it through basic training, and you know what? I love the brotherhood, the camaraderie. Volunteered for airborne school and then ranger training. Man, that was tough, but it gave me confidence. Taught me to trust, taught me about honor. It taught me about the strength that comes from knowing that my fellow soldiers always have my back. In the past 4 years, I have skyrocketed to the rank of staff sergeant. I'm a squad leader now, and there's no other job I'd rather do. It's a tough fight here, but that's exactly what we train for. If the missions were easy, they wouldn't ask us to do it. We are soldiers. We are committed. We will do what is right, and we will do what is necessary.
During Vietnam, the Armed Forces Network, USO shows, and Army bands continued to entertain the troops in the combat zone with songs from home. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the United States Army Drill Team. We ask that no one use flash photography as the soldiers are using real weapons with sharpened bayonets. However, we do encourage you to cheer and applaud the soldiers throughout the performance. Since the birth of our nation, American soldiers have always committed to a professional ethic of values, possess unquestionable character, and are highly competent. The Drill Team is the embodiment of these qualities. Members of the drill team are from all corners of the United States with a wide range of specialties. They have perfected their mission and are here to share it with you today. The United States Army Drill Team. American soldiers have served and sacrificed in the Army to preserve our way of life, our values, and our future. The Army's trusted professionals have, are, and will always be prepared to defend the Constitution of the United States and answer America's call whenever and wherever needed. Today, the drill team is led by their drill master, Sergeant First Class Brian Hines from Athens, Georgia. Thank you. The drill team represents today's soldiers as well as yesterday's heroes who proudly fought in the Revolutionary War and continue to serve in the mountains of Afghanistan, throughout the Middle East, Europe, and Korea. Today, the Army has more than 187,000 soldiers forward deployed in over 140 countries around the world. The Army is manned, equipped, and trained to execute any range of missions. This is done with the same trust, precision, discipline, and professionalism that the drill team displays with each rifle spin and coordinated move. Most difficult maneuver of all. The soldiers will continue to march as members from the front rank toss their rifle into the air over the formation to be caught by the soldier in the rear rank. This is again an exercise in trust as each member will have to put their safety in the hands of their brothers in arms. This is the United States Army Drill Team's signature maneuver since 1958, the front to rear overhead rifle toss.
Battle-tested, soldiers and leaders emerge from Vietnam, determined to bring about changes to our Army, based on lessons learned in our nation's second longest war. Their actions create a highly professional Army that was superbly trained, magnificently equipped, and expertly led. Throughout the last two decades of the 20th century, American soldiers conducted combat operations, humanitarian and peacekeeping missions in places like Grenada, Panama, Somalia, Haiti, and the Balkans. And it was that all-volunteer army that brought nearly five decades of the Cold War to an end with the fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989.
First major foreign crisis for the United States since the end of the Cold War presented itself in August 1990 when Saddam Hussein ordered his army to invade Kuwait. This was no ordinary act of aggression. Iraq's army, the fourth largest in the world, was well equipped with more than 650,000 frontline troops, 4,200 tanks, 700 aircraft, and 3,100 artillery pieces. Iraq's army and its vaunted Republican Guard were also battle-tested, having fought an eight-year war with Iran. Still, in just 100 hours of combat, working side by side with joint coalition partners, our army achieved a stunning victory over the Iraqi forces, liberating Kuwait and demonstrating the professionalism, dedication, and high level of training of our soldiers. added to the history books were victories such as the Battle of Medina Ridge, the Battle of Wadi al-Batin, and the Battle of 73 Eastie, the largest tank battle fought by United States forces since World War II.
Since September 11th, 2001, the men and women of your army have maintained a high state of readiness. American soldiers remain decisively engaged, taking the fight to our enemies around the globe in concert with America's other armed services and our allies. Those who would seek to harm our citizens and threaten our way of life do so at their own peril, while our nation's soldiers stand watch.
My name is Private First Class Yanov Evan, from Kyrgyzstan, Central Asia. I am an American soldier. I am a warrior and a member of a team. I serve the people of the United States and lead the army values. For 241 years, soldiers have served our nation during times of profound change and conflict. One constant is our values: loyalty, duty, respect, honor, integrity, and personal courage. Values that will continue to inspire soldiers for the next 241 years.
I am Specialist Asher Sibby from Chicago, Illinois. I will always place the mission first. Never accept defeat. I will never quit. I will never leave a fallen comrade. I am disciplined, physically and mentally tough, trained and proficient in my warrior's tasks and drills. I will always maintain my arms, my equipment, and myself. These soldiers reflect our warrior ethos: tough, disciplined, talented, and proud of our heritage.
My name is Specialist Javier Flores from Big Timber, Montana. I am an expert and I am a professional. I stand ready to deploy, engage, and destroy the enemies of the United States of America in close combat. I do not do this because I have to. I do it because the nation needs me. I am a guardian of freedom and the American way of life. I am an American soldier,
and we are Army Strong!
The call rang out for volunteers in a nation being born. No sunshine patriot speeches, no summer soldier songs, for the special ones who pay the price to keep the country strong. When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed, we were there. From the frozen fields of Valley Forge to a trail called Ho Chi Minh, through the glory and the sacrifice people are dying day. We are citizens and soldiers, an army all the way. When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed, we were there. No, it wasn't always easy. It wasn't always fair, but when freedom called, we answered, we were there. When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed, we were there. No, it wasn't always easy. It wasn't there.
It has been a pleasure for the United States Army to have presented Twilight Tattoo. Our soldiers will remain on the field and are available to answer your questions and pose for photographs. Thank you for coming out to help us honor the selfless service of American soldiers, past and present. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Army Strong!